Hello friends, today we talk about the most accepted natural system of classification, which was proposed by the George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker. They both are English botanists. The classification was published in their three-volume work, Genera Plantarum. In all, they described 97,205 species belonging to 7,569 genera of 202 families of plants. Bentham and Hooker system of classification is clearly derived from the system of A.P. de Candolle and D. Jesso. So today we talk about the classification of Bentham and Hooker. It is the summary of this classification which they described in their three volume work Genera Plantarum, and they describe 202 families in it. They divided the seed plants or phanerogams, called phanerogams, into three classes: dicotyledons, gymnospermae and monocotyledons, on the basis of those characters. For dicotyledon, first the seed with two cotyledons, flowers penta or tetrameras, and the leaves venation type is net veined. And this dicotyledon class contain 14 series, 25 order and 165 families. And the gymnospermae, which character is ovules naked, it contain 3 families. And for the monocotyledons, the seed with single cotyledon, flower trimeras, venation pattern parallel, and this monocotyledons class contains 7 series and 34 families. Now come to the dicotyledons. This class dicotyledons also subdivided into 3 subclasses: polypetaly, gamopetaly and monoclamide. Polypetaly, here the sepals and petals distinct and petals are free, so it's polypetaly. And for gamopetaly, sepals and petals distinct but petals are united, means gamo. So in case of polypetaly, petals are free. In case of gamopetaly, their petals are united. But in case of monoclamide, they are apetalous. That means petals are absent. Perianth, absent, or if present, not differentiated into sepalous perianth and petalous perianth. Now the polypetaly. This subclass polypetaly further divided into 3 series: thalamiflori, disciflori and calyciflori. Thalamiflori characters hypogynous flower, stamens many, disc absent. And disciflori, hypogynous flower, disc present below the ovary. And for calyciflori, those are perigynous or epigynous flower. That means in case of thalamiflori, they are hypogynous flower. Disciflori, they are also hypogynous flower, but in thalamiflori they have not any disc. But for the disciflori, their disc present below the ovary. And calyciflori, they are not hypogynous, they are perigynous or epigynous flower. Now this thalamiflori series also further divided into 6 order. Those are ranalis, parietalis, polygalani, caryophyllini, gutiferalis and malvellis. Next, disciflori, it's also further divided into 4 order. Those are geranialis, olacellis, cleastralis and sapindalis. Calyciflori divided into 5 order: rosalis, myrtalis, passifloralis, ficoidalis and umbellalis. Now come to the subclass gamopetaly. Gametophyte also divided into three series: inferi, heteromeri, and bicarpellate. In case of inferi, there is ovary inferior, but for the heteromeri and bicarpellate, both are ovary superior. In case of heteromeri, the stamens are one or two whole and carpel more than two. But for the bicarpellate, ovary superior, stamens in one whole and the carpel number is two. So it's called bicarpellate because the carpel number is two. There the carpel number is more than two. The series inferi next divided into three order: rubialis, asterales, and campanellis. And heteromeri also divided into three order: ericalis, primulalis, and ebenalis. Bicarpellate further divided into four order: nitalis, polymonialis, personalis, lamialis. Now we come to the subclass monoclamidae. Monoclamidae divided into eight series. First, carp embryi. Their character: embryo coiled and ovule number is 1. Multi-ovulate aquatica. They are aquatic plants and ovules number is many. Ovules are many. And for multi-ovulate terrestrialis, those are terrestrial plants and ovules many. Fourth, microembryi, where the embryo is minute. Next, the daphonalis, carpel number 1 and ovule number 1. Next, acclamidospori, where ovary inferior, unilocular and ovule number 1, 2, 3. Next series, unisexualis, where the flowers are unisexual. And the last one is ordinis anomaly, where the relationship uncertain. So the dicotyledons classes divided into three subclass: polypetaly, gametophyte, and monoclamidae. This polypetaly further divided into three series and gametophyte also in three series and the monoclamidae in eight series. Now we come to the monocotyledons. This class directly divided into seven series. There is no subclass. First one is microspermy, where the ovary inferior and seeds minute. Next, the epigyny, where the ovary inferior but seeds are large. Next, the coronary, where ovary superior, carpels united and perianth colorful. Next, the callosemy, where the ovary superior, carpels united but perianth is green. So coronary and callosemy, the difference: in case of coronary, perianth is colorful, but in case of callosemy, the perianth color is green. Next, nudiflorae, where ovary superior but perianth absent. Next, apocarpy, where the ovary superior, carpels more than one and free. The last one is gloomiflorae, where ovary superior, perianth reduced and flower enclosed in glumes. Thus the name gloomiflorae. So it is the overall classification of Bentham and Hooker. Though the system does not incorporate any phylogenetic relationship and is more than 100 years old, it still enjoys a reputation of being a very sound system of classification. So that's all. If anyone have any doubt or any question, you can comment in comment box. Thank you.